Hey, good evening, everybody out there in Chester County, Coatesville, and on my Facebook page, coming to you live on City Town Talk on a tantalizing Tuesday is none other than me, Brother Fonz. And I'm just going to play my theme music just for a second to give viewers the opportunity to get on, because I think we're going to have an interesting interview tonight. As a matter of fact, I am the special guest for this evening. Brother Fonz Newsign, president of the Movement Community Development Corporation. So I want y'all to sign on in. Give me a holler, because I always like to meet and greet and give shout outs, recognize you and tell you that I appreciate you. So this is good and it's interesting. Facebook and Zoom has a new interface, and it's like I'm hearing impaired, and it's got all my words coming across the screen on my phone. It threw me off the other day, but I think I got it down pat now. So come on, and let's see what we got here. Yep, it is a beautiful day today, tantalizing Tuesday. I do understand that when you do this Zoom thing, sometimes it's a little delayed, and I don't want to put all my ducks in a row just yet, because I do want as many people to understand and hear what's going on. Let me see if we can't take it back a little bit. Okay, I see one, numero uno. Put your name down there, let me know who you are. I'm feeling pretty good. Allergies killing me. I'm digging a hole in my eyes. The corner of my eye feels like raw meat. It is something, I'm telling you. I know one thing. I can't look at the words that's on my screen because it's about 2 minutes late. Woo! I'm just looking there to see if I can recognize and say hi to anybody that is out there in Chester County. And on my Facebook page. Who are you? Where are you? Evelyn Johnson, where are you? Iris Holmes, check in. Let me know that you're out there somewhere. Where are you? Where are you? Do I have anybody out there? Or are y'all just waiting for me to start running my mouth? And that's okay. We're going to give it 30 more seconds, and then I'm going to get ready to go and tell you what's going on. Yo, this is, you know, technology is something else. This modern interface, this new interface has really got me tripping, but it is better. But you know, when you're doing something new, it's a little uncomfortable. But man, I just want to say, I am so glad to be here, man. God is amazing what he's doing in my life and how he's allowed me to see another day, because Lord knows. Iris, it's good to see you. And Iris, thank you for sharing this video. I think I was waiting for you, Iris, so I guess now I can cut the music down and start talking about what I want to talk about. Yes, 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 yes. Good evening, everybody out there. Once again, in Chester County, Coatesville, and on my Facebook page. It is truly a pleasure and an honor to be sitting here being my own guest on my own show. That is okay. You know how God works, right? Between Saturday, with all the festivities and the Ash Park meeting that we had Saturday, Eric, thank you for sharing, Eric Myers right there. You know how God places certain things that sets things up so things can just go in a beautiful kind of like time and everything. So I'm going to springboard off of the event at Ash Park Saturday into what I'm going to talk about today. Now, first, I want to just say hi to everybody. And until I see you on here, I won't be able to greet you, but that's okay, because I know you're out there somewhere. Okay. A lot of people, I think it's important for me to let everybody within the sound of my voice know who MCDC is. MCDC is a solution-based nonprofit whose vision statement centers around transforming Coatesville communities by strengthening families and generating leaders. Our mission is to empower and educate the residents of Coatesville of the various resources through the community. We will partner with our community by connecting with local officials and organizations that will successfully help Coatesville thrive as a sustainable community. And we're going to talk about them relationships just a little bit later in my presentation, because we have made some relationships. But today, a question was posed to me on my page, and it goes something like this. Why would you give hope to people when you knew you weren't going to be successful? This is in reference to us not being successful in actually restoring and reopening Ash Park Pool. So my answer is this. For us to try to provide hope to a community knowing that we couldn't do it would make us all con men and con women. That's what con people do. Make you believe that they can deliver a service when they know that they can't. So there are seven members who are presently on MCDC, and there were others when we first came to and made this resolution that was on there, including our county commissioner, Josh Maxwell, and so many other illustrious people. So let's keep that in mind. Now we're going to talk about the word hope. At no time did we think we couldn't do it. We moved out on faith, and as far as giving hope to people is concerned, that's who we are. We are a group that wishes to give hope and do the best we can to provide solutions for the things that need to be addressed in our community. We can't do it all, so there's more than enough room for as many advocates Coatesville can get to give voice and hope to those who think things are hopeless, to dare try to do what others won't. We are hope dealers. Now, our faith is in God, but we believe if we step out on faith that God will deliver us and give us the fruits and the rewards of our efforts. And it may not wind up being what it started out to be, but we believe he will do something positive if we truly, truly believe. And that's what hope is about. We are hope dealers. There's seven of us left right now. That's what we do. Now, I'm going to tell you about some other things, other hope that we're pressing on people who are leaning on it and hope that it comes true. Okay, first I want to introduce the people who make up MCDC. First, there's Rhonda Andrews. Rhonda Andrews has been with me approximately 10 years, has helped organize and provide stability for mentoring ministry that I led at New Life in Christ for 5 years. We have served over 13,000 meals and coordinated numerous adventures and outside activities for the youth. She constructed all of the paperwork, which is so important when you're dealing with the children of our community. She provided us with a blueprint, and she was also the main organizer, record keeper of the Not So Secret Santa initiative that was created by me for 5 years. And she helped organize the records and distribution of entire Christmas gift lists for hundreds of kids. Oh man, I'll tell you the story about that. She's a definite whiz with an Excel spreadsheet. These gifts were donated by you, the community at large, and we met at my house the Friday before every Christmas with neighbors, city council members, and friends to wrap two floors of gifts, eat food like we were dogs, and then distribute them secretly to their families. We had 5 years of community members coming into my home as guest wrappers to be part of the fellowship of food and distributing gifts to those who needed them. That's an ad lib. She's now the secretary of MCDC, and she's the lead contact for our first hometown buyers program, collaborating with the Housing Partnership, Second Century, Open Hearth, and Habitat for Humanity to help make our program in Coatesville a success. Next is Iris Holmes. She's a super spiritual one in this bunch, man. She keeps me on an even keel because she keeps a scripture or a kind word when things are a little crazy. Iris Holmes is the original member, one of the original members of the movement, for those of you who can't remember the movement, who stood up and for children in the Coatesville Area School District and its employees. I know Iris remembers because we all had red sweatshirts, red shirts with the words can't stop, won't stop. That's where our logo came from, created by Marie Hess at that time. Iris has fought against an educational hierarchy that doomed our students, district, and communities to fail. Iris Holmes has been a community advocate with me for at least 9 years. She now serves on the planning committee on MCDC and is presently working on 3 scholarship programs for our community. Physicians of Tomorrow Scholarship, Community Outreach / Activism Scholarship, and Coatesville Futures, with, in parentheses, Small Business Leaders Scholarship. Next member of MCDC is Delina DeVoe, one of our newest members. She's the planning committee leader that is undertaking the same scholarship program. Delina has given it leadership and we're all excited to see it bear fruit. Delina was also the lead on our MCDC gala that disappointingly couldn't be held because of COVID-19 and its quarantine. Next is my man, Big E, Eric Myers, ladies and gentlemen. Eric Myers is a lifelong resident of Coatesville. Now, remember, giving hope to people when you know that it's not going to happen makes us all con men and con women. These are the people that you are considering to be con artists. Eric Myers, lifelong resident of Coatesville, has served in many capacities at New Life in Christ Fellowship. Eric's goal at MCDC, and this is really, really his goal, is to bring training here to Coatesville, if at all possible. And his main concern is that they be good paying jobs. Now, I'm gonna tell you the truth now. There's some companies that came in that's gonna start off at $15 an hour. That's not what Eric is talking about. See, because we got this first-time home buyers program, and Eric at every meeting, he's like, yo, man, but they gotta have jobs so they can keep their homes. Eric's pet peeve and his thing, and it's going to happen. COVID-19 got all in the way. Let me see if I can see some comments here. COVID got in the way, and me and Eric, hey, did I see Jackie Alamine? Me and Eric drove 600 miles with me to Erie, Pennsylvania to find out how we can make that happen. You understand? Thank God he can drive, because I'd have never got there, because I'd be in the bathroom every half hour. But anyway, where was that with Eric? We are attempting to engage in the trade unions to make that possible. COVID-19 has created a challenge, but his enthusiasm is undaunted. Eric is also on the scholarship planning committee, and he is instrumental in turning this vision into a reality. He has coordinated and gave leadership to our 2 block party fundraisers, and that was quite a job. And he did a great job. Or I just mentioned, Eric was also the driver as we went 600 miles through the convention to see how we could better serve our community and the network with city and network with city managers from all over Pennsylvania. Gaining knowledge and contacts that would further help our mission to strengthen families and create community leaders. Let me take a second to say hi to some people, because I don't want y'all, because y'all are really the most important person. Good evening, Jackie, Iris. Hey, Brother E, Iris said, God gives us hope every day. That's why we have to do what we can do and let God do the rest. Amen. Donald Anderson, it's good to see you. Iris said, COVID-19 has no authority over God's plan. Right, because stuff is still happening in spite of COVID-19. We just had to redo what we do. Okay, but wait a minute. So now let's talk about Alan Tyrone Smith. Alan Tyrone Smith is the borough manager of South Coatesville, a minister and a saxophonist. Y'all ever can pick up one of his tracks on iTunes, you ought to get it. That brother can blow, man. He's funny. Alan Tyrone Smith is the architect and co-grant writer that's spearheading a home rehabilitation program at MCDC for those who are at poverty level or under. For whose homes are in need of repair and money is an issue. Ricky Campbell and myself have inspected approximately 45 homes and have assessed their needs for repairs and have documented them and included it in our rehabilitation grant. That grant will provide them with relief help and hopefully save their homes. You hear that word, hopefully, right? Look, while I'm praying, I hope we get that grant. We're gonna know sure. But see, that's what hope's about. You step out on faith, you trust in the one who can make this thing happen for me, that's God. He can make it happen. And I step out on faith and yeah, I hope it'll work, but I hope that he will make it happen. I'm not gonna parse words when I use the word hope. Yes, it is about giving hope to the hopeless and voice to the voiceless. We never have a guarantee how things will turn out. only thing we are responsible for is giving it the best that we got. I'm going to talk about this just a little bit more because I don't want negativity to affect a vast community when we are trying to raise up leaders. We are not guaranteed to succeed all the time, but we are never to give up or give in. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, Jacqueline Carter, top of the evening to you, Tina Zeller, and my man, Courtney Levine. Hey, let me tell y'all something. Y'all didn't know this, and it's my fault. But tonight's interview with Fonz is brought to you by Courtney Levine, who is a bona fide licensed certified electrician who does fantastic work. He is from the community. And I vouch for him because he doesn't work, because I turn off all the electricity to or change the light bulb. And this show tonight is also brought to you by Allen's on First. Ladies and gentlemen, three black women open up a pizza shop. Now, let me tell you something. We all had excuses why we used to go to everywhere else to get a pizza. We no longer have that excuse. We have three black women that have opened up a pizza shop on First Avenue, are employing 10 people from the community that looks just like us. We are responsible to keep them open, not just for their benefit, but for the 10 people that work for them and the families they got to feed. Come on, can I get an amen anywhere? Can I? That's what I'm talking about. So don't get me started on Allen's on First. I've never seen three black women open up a pizza. Matter of fact, I know other people have, but I don't know a black person that owns a pizza shop. Hey, Dion, it is so good to see you. I'm glad that you tuned in. Can you share this with people? Because I think we need to talk to the community about who MCD is. And for those who say, why you want to give hope to people when you know something ain't going to succeed? Well, hell, I don't know what's going to succeed, so I ain't never going to stop passing out hope. That might be the time that it do. And then it all depends who you believe in on. But I'm going to show you what hope and stepping out on faith will do, because I've learned in life that sometimes when you shoot for the sun, you mess around and land amongst the stars. And I'm going to show you some of the stars that we've landed in while we were on this mission. Kimberly Day Hardy, top of the evening to you. I'm preaching this evening, Kimberly. We're talking about who MCDC is. We are not who some of you think we are. That's Eric Myers. Now, let me finish with Alan Tyrone Smith. Oh, no. It's time for me to talk about Ricky Campbell, who is the treasurer. So if y'all ever think something's going on with the money, you might want to call Ricky, because I ain't even allowed to touch it. And I don't want to touch it. I'm busy. My head already hurt with all the phone calls and all the stuff I'm trying to do. Chef. But here we go. The next member of MCDC is Ricky Campbell. He is the treasurer of MCDC, a deacon, a minister at Passdown Baptist Church, an assistant to State Rep Dan Williams. He co-leads with Darfur, Doc's best kept secret, Saunders, in an initiative whereby, listen to this, whereby they take our children, meaning the community's children, and teach them how to work with their hands. Because you know Ricky Campbell, he owns a lot of properties, and him and Darfur is taking our kids and teaching them how to fix them. Lawnmowers, hang sheetrock, stuff I don't know how to do. And he does that, and I don't know how, because he wears 100 hats. Out of his own, he picks t-shirts and makes it for the kids and all that stuff. He does all that out of his pocket. Ricky and Darfur are longtime businessmen in Coatesville. Ricky Campbell owns numerous properties, and they are teaching our community children all things in regards to working on a house. COVID-19 has created a challenge, but love for what they're doing has not diminished. Ricky Campbell has taken it upon himself, even when I couldn't make it on occasions, continue to do assessments. When we were doing those 45 homes, trying to find money to repair people's homes that aren't our family members, giving them hope that we might can get this money while we were trying to give them hope. Sometimes Brother Fonz couldn't make it. Sometimes Brother Fonz feed her, back her. I'm telling you, look. And you know that, brother? Man, you ain't got to come, Fonz. I got that. And really, I was never necessary, because he the one that know. He go right in the house and said, yep, you need a drain, you need a gym. All I was there was for company, but I wanted to be involved. And it's important. And he did a fine job. And there were times when I couldn't go. Didn't stop him. He is truly, truly a blessing. I'm trying to see if I missed anybody, because that's who MCDC is. The for the negative people, that's who you want to cast aspersions on. Every person's name that I've read does something in the community and sacrifices their time and resources. So if you're worrying about $4 from a t-shirt, you might not have to. But I'm going to answer the question about Ash Park, but I just wanted you to know who MCDC is first. Next, we have been blessed on our journey to have people such as Jackie Alameen, Mary Kyle, Chris Pielli, Debbie Bookman, Pastor Rob Marshall spend time in our organization and lend their invaluable services to the mission of MCDC. Jackie Alameen was instrumental in us getting our grant due to her close relationship with Senator Dinneman and her close ties to other public servants had made it possible to us to branch out and curry favor with public servants to such an extent when we need letters of support for the things that we needed, we could get them. So we owe Jackie Alameen a big debt of gratitude. Next, a special thanks for Mary E. Kyle. Unmatched by anybody. She's an organization unto herself. Mary Kyle, whose enthusiasm is infectious and never ending, always strives to do and be the best that she and our organization could be. Sometimes you have to tell her, stop, please, that's enough. And she working down there with James Logan and Coles. Look, y'all better cut y'all grass and do what y'all supposed to do, because she's no joke. She's about being effective and following the guidelines that are set forth for her. Okay, last but not least, I am the last. I'm just a guy blessed by God to be able to hang around some people that honestly believe that they can make a difference. I come from South Philly, man. I did drugs for 30 years. I wasn't around nobody that believed they could make a difference, especially not seven of them. And right now I'm in the midst of them. And I ain't the sharpest knife in the drawer, and I don't have to be. But God has blessed me with some people that when I call, they're there. When I don't have an answer, they got it. They don't make me feel like I'm dumb. They just keep doing what they're doing. And they never say a mumbling word. Now the Ash part. I'm going to answer the biggest question first. People want to know, well, where's the money from the t-shirts and where's the money if anybody donated or whatever? Where's it at? In the bank. Now, my next is in the bank. Now, a feasibility study was done by Natural Lands, and it came back that restoring and attempting to open Ash Park Pool was virtually impossible. Of course, we didn't know that at the beginning. Else we'd have never started. We could have been working on something else. But I'm glad we did start. And I'm going to tell you why. This is how God do. Wait a minute. Because see, what some people see as a failure sometimes is a springboard to the ultimate doggone success. I don't even know how he did, but wait a minute. Okay. And it's attempting virtually impossible. Of course, at the onset, we had no idea this was going to be done. Senator Dinneman, realizing right before he retired, that the grant he gave us was about to expire, which is June of this year. One of his last acts before he retired was to call people of authority in our community to figure out how we could at least keep the $200,000. This conversation was held with Senator Dinneman, City Manager, Brandywine Health Organization, Executive Director, MCDC board members, and Natural Lands. The consensus was use it or lose it. And that's almost like that thing about Solomon with the two mothers was claiming the baby, like who's the mother? Will you cut the baby in half to spite the, come on, man. So the choice was use it or lose it. Well, that was the easy one for us. Where's that? Okay. So the termination on this grant was scheduled for June of this year. In conclusion, Senator Dinneman stated that it would be best to turn it over to the city, include it in the Ash Park plan, and use it to add to the creation of a water feature. Let me see if I got any questions out there. Am I boring anybody? Look, let me tell you something. Man, God is amazing. Man, look, he took a group of fledgling people who dared to believe that they could do something that was seemingly impossible. And in the midst of flipping the script, in the midst of lemons coming on the scene, he decided, I will still add some sugar to that. And we're going to turn some of that into lemonade. So now, where am I at talking about this? Now, the last t-shirt that we sold was in August of the year 2019. That's almost 2 years ago. COVID-19 has prevented any and all fundraisers. The account we set up at Coastal Savings Bank has yet to receive a dime, and we set that up in the year 2017. If not for Anthony Beatman Wilson and Kia of Coatesville, we wouldn't have had the initial block party, because Anthony Wilson got us $5,000, and that paid for the train, the games, and everything, because we didn't have the money. So that day when we sold the tickets, I think we sold about $4,000 worth of tickets. We could keep that. Thank God. Can you imagine? We paid $5,000 for them trains and games and got $4,000 worth of tickets. Or when I say tickets, I mean tickets and t-shirts. We'd have lost $1,000. So we were blessed there. Okay, we're the second block party lost money because we needed a sponsor then again, because we ain't handle $5,000. All right, but anyway, all right, so we pay dues out of our own pockets. Our dues goes toward when we used to meet. We buy pizzas, and you know who just had to go get the pizzas? It was me. At first Monday of every month, we didn't get pizzas. We pay $120 a year out of seven. It'd be like, you know, we had like $800 to $900. And that's what we did. Okay, now where we at? Monies from t-shirt sales and hoodies will remain in the account set up for the pool and will go towards a water feature that will be constructed. I want to take the time to thank all of you who purchased an item or donated any money, that we will continue to be good stewards of what you've entrusted to us. Now, what I would like to demand is two things. One is some sort of memorial plaque that will last throughout time, as long as Ash Park exists, for Bubba Lop. I don't care if you got to do it in stone, how you got to do it, but that's one of my dreams and wishes. John Miller, it's good to see you, because I don't know if I mentioned you, man, but it's good. Melanie Smiley. Oh, Melanie, I haven't seen you in a while. A plaque for Bubba Lop. And I want a real good one. And one to honor the citizens of Coatesville who had hope shown by investing and buying a t-shirt or a hoodie. Now, people donating straight cash was so small. But even those, them, everybody who did anything, I think they need to be recognized during this course of time in a memorial that will last forever. Because for 2 years, Coatesville stood up and tried to make a difference in a seemingly impossible mission. Seemingly impossible mission. Okay. Yeah. All right. I also want to thank the members of MCDC. While no one was looking, MCDC was meeting, begging, praying, working, hoping, and trying to engage the community in a way that we all could be proud of, man. All of them. They never lost hope. They just kept doing what they were doing till the end, till the decision came that it just can't happen. And that's going to happen in every one of our lives. There's going to be one thing that you will not be successful for. So, Fonz, what do you do when that happens? Well, from what I understand, when you get knocked down seven, you get up eight. Because I fail in one thing doesn't make me a failure. That just means I say, well, what's next? Well, here we go. Let's talk about it. Life is just not about the goal, but it's about the journey. While traveling towards your goal, who did you meet? Who did you help? What did you say? Were you being mindful of what's happening and who you met on the journey? Because if you do, this may take you in a whole different direction. I interviewed a young lady who wanted to be a singer and an actress, and she's in Jersey raising chickens and happy as her chickens. You all know Deidre Valentina Holmes. Started one way, but God moved her in a different direction. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go to my YouTube channel and look up her interview. If we had never attempted to do what seemingly seemed impossible, we would have never received the grant for the first-time home buyers program, because we would not have been together. We would not have been trying to find out ways to do things for others. And because we stayed on that journey, we got to meet people who had wisdom, ideas, and opened doors and showed us stuff that we weren't aware of. And so, to our surprise, we have been funded to pay for a project manager and some little incidental paper and whatever supplies we need to help people become first-time home buyers, because that strengthens your community when you turn people away from being renters and homeowners. That's in our mission and vision statement. That's who we are, but we don't realize that if we look at something that is so humongous and say, we can't do that. Because if everything you strive to do is right within your purview of I can do that, then your dreams and your thoughts and hopes are too small. Now, they may be okay for you, but because we are an organization, we want to do things that only God can bless us to do, because we're trying to do some big stuff and we ain't got no money. Is that good English? We ain't got no. Wait, there's more. My baby cake's coming home. If we hadn't attempted to do this pool, we would have never came across Alan Tyrone Smith, who said, Fonz, I did this for a community in Chester, and I got them X amount of dollars. Sure did, too, because they sent out them notifications from the government saying who got what. And everything. Look, the only one person got the grant that he did in Coatesville. Only one person. So we put in for something that is historical. And yes, I'm going to tell you how much we asked for. Alan will tell you, we asked for $500,000. We don't do that if we don't try to open the pool. Guess what the $500,000 is for? Citizens in the community that we were just talking about the rehabilitation plan, who is suffering from leaky floors, leaky ceilings, kitchens that's fallen, walls that's exposed, electricity that's jacked up, for widows and people that's living under the poverty line who needs help. But nobody knocks on their door, or they don't know where to get the resources and the help. That's part of our vision and mission as well. Iris said, if we touch one life, our mission is not in vain. And she's right, because that's what we're about. Now, we're going to be trying to do a lot of things, so you may be hearing about more failures in the future. I can't guarantee we're going to knock everything out the park. If we hadn't gone for that pool, we wouldn't have met people and gotten letters of support for our initiatives. Let me see. I think I got their names down here somewhere. I know I was supposed to mention their names. I want to be name droppers, because when it says we want to partner with organizations and local officials, I wrote down who some of these people are, but what did I do with it? Come on, Fonz. You can find it. You can find it. Okay, here are some of the people. Okay, I missed number 10, a special note of importance. The grants that we applied for in regards to first-time home ownership and home rehabilitation has received letters of support from our state representative, Dan K. Williams, retired state senator, Andrew Denneman, county commissioner, Josh Maxwell, county commissioner, Marion Moskowitz, executive director of OIC, Miss Joyce Chester, executive director of the Brandywine Health Foundation, Miss Vanessa Briggs, and you know she'd be doing a lot of stuff for the community, everybody, and state senator Carolyn Comita. Letters of support for our initiatives, because they see that we're trying to help the they ain't putting their signature and applying their letterhead to anybody that's trying to steal some stuff. Juanisha, how are you? See, this is how God worked out, because had we not went after that pool, we have no initiative to get letters of support for them to back us on. Now we have created relationships, MCDC, and all our humble and broke glory. I ain't gonna say everybody broke, because I think Ricky Campbell and Eric Myers got money, but I know I don't. So had we not took that first step on what seemingly seemed impossible, our sphere of influence would have never grown. Met people I thought I'd never meet, got them, context them, and get an answer like that. And they don't give a whole lot of favors, man, because I'm not going to ask for a lot of favors, because I'm not going to use the relationship to be selfishly driven. But when I need somebody's help to help push something that we are legitimately and pushing, can you take a look and see what's up with that? That's what relationships is about. That's what we were doing when some of y'all have been sleeping and trying to figure out how you can dig a hole in people's backs that's doing something positive. Now, if you ever have a question about MCDC and anything, because we'll probably never do another fun. Well, I ain't gonna say that. We're going to have to do some fundraisers at some point in time just so we can keep the lights on when we get an office building or something like that. But we haven't asked for no money since 2019. We don't, nothing. We don't ask for nothing, none. But those nine people aren't con men and women. They haven't conned all these public servants. Because they see the heart of the people. They follow the posts too. They follow Facebook. They know we're always trying to provide information that impacts others. We never say, look at me or look at us. We say what we're trying to do, and what we're trying to do is always to impact somebody else. And we want people to know so you can get involved and be a part of that. That's what we do. Let me see, is there anything else I got? Now look, if anybody got any questions, that's Brooklyn Green. Brooklyn Green, for those of you who don't know, is Bakari Green's daughter and Jackie Alamine's granddaughter. She's trying to make an impact in Coatesville from North Carolina A&T as a chemical engineer wanting to study petroleum. Only thing I know that's petroleum was that petroleum jelly I used to put on my face. So thick, Brooklyn, so thick. These are people that's trying to make a positive impact. We really just, look, I ain't mad at people that want to be negative, but we kind of like don't have time for it. we really don't. But we love you, we bless you, and we're going to try and have an impact on your life if you ever put in for any of our initiatives, and some have. And we're going to try to provide them relief. Even though I know they want to dig a hole in our backs. Because that's what Christ calls us to do. To help those who spitefully try to talk about you and all that. If I just dig the people that like me, man, what's that? I don't want to get all religious on y'all. Hey, look. Okay, so here's something that y'all can do for us. For those of you, hey, Brooklyn, you're laughing. It ain't funny. So for those of y'all, we're the working members and board members of MCDC. We do all the work. We don't have no volunteers. So when we had the block party, it was like nobody talking about, man, I can't come because I got stuff to do. No, man, everybody had to put on their working clothes. And that's how we do what we do. But look, this is how the community can help. We put in a grant for $500,000 to give to members of the community. Not just give it to y'all now. We already got a list of everything that y'all need in the 45 homes. Trust me, it was typed out in the grant, so it'll be no shenanigans. But pray for us. Don't try to dig a hole in our back. Pray for us, because God blesses us to bless our community. That's what this whole thing is about. That's what MCDC was for. You know good and well, we can't swim. We wasn't trying to get the pool open for us. I'm 70. I ain't got no little kids. I do got grandkids, though. We were trying to do it for our community, and that's the role we will continue to roll on as new problems need solutions, or we see a new need, we're going to jump on it. Now, before I go anywhere, Brooklyn, I'll tell you, Brooklyn, you might want to donate to this or something because you're pretty smart and got money. For Physicians of Tomorrow, this is one of the three scholarship programs we're setting up. Physicians of Tomorrow. The Coatesville community is known for its rich history of African-American physicians and medical personnel who have pioneered the medical field with undying dedication and services to the residents of Coatesville and surrounding areas. In memory of Dr. A.C. Atkinson, Dr. Charles Butler, Dr. Daniel Lee, and Dr. Lewis Stokes, this scholarship is awarded to the minority student who exemplifies, and here exemplifies this, favorable attendance at the Coatesville Area High School, scholastic achievement 3.0 or higher, strong interest in the medical field, 4, a passion for healthy living and promoting healthy lifestyles. All these doctors was here before I got here. And we're trying to honor our students through their legacy. Look, man, we're trying to do some big stuff here. We do not have time to try and give somebody $3 back on a t-shirt. Matter of fact, we ain't going to do it. And for those of you, you go around trying to figure out who donated what. And when you get a list, come back and holler at your brother. Yeah, we're all the questions. Is there anybody got questions out here? Because I am so here for you. I have no time limit. I am my own special guest, so I have nowhere to go. Now, that's the first scholarship. See, because we're busy right now because we see we need to provide an impact on our community in our own little clique. And there's room for a lot of cliques, but it's not no room for competition. You don't have to make yourself look big by making other people look small. That's what brings everything down. And don't you think I don't know that's what's going on, but that's okay. It's not for me to call you out, but I'm here to try and help you if your main goal and plan is for us all to rise, because a rising tide lifts all boats. Be part of the rising tide. Now, the second one, look, Delina, Eric, and Iris put this together. Community outreach / activism. MCDC celebrates and encourages the spirit of community development and growth. The scholarship is awarded to the individual who is pursuing a career in socioeconomics, community development, or other related areas. I ain't gonna read the rest of it. I'm gonna just tell you what it needs. You have to have demonstrated leadership, excellence of character and integrity, community involvement with demonstrated dedication to community service, and received an acceptance letter from a local college or university. But they're not the only one that's going to be blessed, Tina. I'm glad you finally checked in, because we want to do something for people that don't want to go to college, because everybody don't want to go to college. It ain't for everybody. I went to college for 6 months, but that don't even count. Coatesville Futures, in parentheses, small business leaders. Understanding that all life's lessons are not taught in a classroom setting, MCDC honors the spirit of entrepreneurialism. And we got some in this town. And you know, we got Reese Soaps up there in the Midway, and we got Mimi's Favorite Things. We got all those people. We got all those people. Now look, this scholarship is awarded to the life learner who is looking to forge a path of ownership with a strong desire to bring thriving business to the Coatesville and surrounding area. This scholarship is awarded to the individual who has an entrepreneurial spirit and dream to change the future, has a clear business plan, and does not possess a degree from 2 or 4 year college when applying. And there's no age limit on that. So, Reese Turner, you can apply for that. Okay. For those of you out there who strive to do big things, better things, and everything, remember, you never have to apologize for results when you've done the best that you can. Never. Knock down 7, get the heck up 8. Keep hope alive. Understand there's going to be naysayers. Don't let that be an excuse for you to get off the hope train. Don't let that be an excuse for you to stop doing what you know in your heart is right. You know what? You know why I'm busy and keep stepping, even though there's a little something in the air? Because we're on a mission. We're on a mission because there's still 45 people that is hoping that this will happen for them. We still have renters who's in our first time home buyers program who has never owned a home, and it appears to be hopeless. And you know what? We are here to try to do help in any and every way that we can for them to achieve their possible dream. I got a crib. I'm good. But to achieve their goal, that's what we're here for. And that's what I'm going to keep doing while I'm on this side of earth, because I've taken all my life, been selfish all my life. And once the Lord turned my life around, not that he made me perfect, but he let me see who I am. And he let me see, well, the same way you was when you was out there fiending and how you was gung-ho and you would never quit. Do something good for people and don't stop. So that's why I'm on here all day, every day. That's why I'm telling you about this COVID-19 vaccines at New Life Tomorrow. That's why I'm telling you that there's $34.5 million for people who are suffering financially from COVID-19, and there's money for you if you do the application. That's why we are constantly giving out information that will impact those who ever will listen and take a step to try and achieve what we're talking about. And we're not going to stop doing it. I wish a failure would. Many times I've failed stuff. But I'm smart enough to know that we got the money in the bank. You would never be able to do that one. But this is for the other people. Because you're going to hit some obstacles, man. Let me tell you something. God is amazing. Everything that we've needed, and every step of the way, Except that final resolution that said the pool can be done. But he sent us Jackie, he sent us Mary, he sent everybody that we started out with jugs on a table, and all of a sudden there's $200,000 in a look. Let me clear that up. A $200,000 grant is not money in our bank account, okay? It's a piece of paper. In case y'all don't know. Matter of fact, I still got the paper upstairs, although it's no good because it has been changed and given to the city. And that took a whole lot of paperwork. You got to go back to Harrisburg. You got to redo stuff. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. You got to sign off on stuff. It ain't just like, here, y'all. Mm-mm. So we thank the city for allowing us to still use that grant for something positive. They didn't have to. And it was voted on by city council and said, yes, let's go ahead and do it. Hey, look, don't tell them, Mary. They don't want to read that right now. Hey, Levi, I'll put the link on your page. You'll be able to see it, man. It's like Fonz is a special guest tonight, and I'm interviewing myself. And I'm just using this time to talk from my heart now, because I don't have no more type stuff. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something about what's going on in Coatesville. Entrepreneurs are springing up. The mindset is changing. Now, some people's not going to want to change with this new mindset. Some people are going to cling on to the past. And it's okay. You got to let them stay there. You know, and you don't spend time trying to convert them, because what it will divert you trying to convert them. Keep doing what you're doing. Ronette Jones Holmes, keep doing what you're doing. Whether it's seen or unseen, you are impacting people and a community around you. Sometimes you may not see the fruits of your labor. Plant the seed of positivity. Plant inside each person the ability to see that they can do and can be, and then you can move on. I mean, you can help where you can, but you don't have to stand in the light. I feel so good about the Ash Park thing Saturday, because it gave us the opportunity to bring this thing to a head. Because I spoke at the park, but there wasn't enough community people at the park. See, the park that everybody's worried about, the pool that everybody's worried about, I'm on the Ash Park Pool Commission. Ricky Campbell, Jackie Alamine, Marie, I keep forgetting your last name. I always remember it as Marie Hess. We got Shannon Thomas. We are all on that commission. So we've been riding this thing, trying to make things happen, get the consensus of the neighborhood and this and that. Yeah. But that's all that was there. When they had these big meetings talking about the pool, 15 people out of 13,000 showed up. But when you think somebody brought a t-shirt and now you don't have a pool, you wonder why and where's the money? In the bank. But that's your first concern. The main concern was to have a community consensus. Who knows if 13,000 people say we don't want what you want, natural lands. We want what we want. Maybe that might have made a difference. I don't know because it never happened. But when you don't show up, it gives a carte blanche to those who want to plan what they want to plan with our stuff, the ability to do it. And I can't blame them. If you don't show up, they got to come up with something. And they are trying to do something good. The new park that they plan, it looks nice. It ain't got our pool, but it looks nice and the community will benefit from it. Mary said, the community has to come off social media and show the hell up. Well, look, city council meetings are now on Zoom. You don't even have to leave your house. I was on a Zoom meeting last week. Y'all wasn't there. They were talking about what they were going to do with the Coatesville Record. Do y'all know what they're going to do? Or are you going to listen to the guy who lives next door to you that never make a meeting and then tell you something crazy? I had somebody come and tell me something crazy. Nah, I ain't going to talk about it because then they'll know I know what they, I ain't going to do it. Anyway, do you know what they plan for Coatesville Record? A restaurant called the Coatesville Tap and axe throwing event, not event, but axe playing, axe throwing piece up there where Angry Jacks, you do axe throwing. Did you know that? Or are you going to wait till they start building and say, man, don't nobody want no axe throwing? Too late. When they were presenting it to the city council, nobody showed up. All right, look, I think, hey, Mary, you think I'm talked enough? It's 8:52. I done ran my mouth a whole lot. Lawson, thank you, Levi. Thank you, Marie Hess, Marie Lawson. I'm sorry. Marie, forgive me for using Hess counter to my head, not to my heart, because, like, that's what I said. I forgot. But, Levi, hey, Levi, I really love you, man. I got man love for you, man, for so many different reasons. So many different reasons. And because you're pretty doggone genuine, man. You're so genuine, you're almost stupid. You remind me, God, like me. God. Anyway, here's my phone number. I am the president of the Movement Community Development Corporation, and my phone number is 484-734-0891. My line is always open for you in regards to questions about what we are trying to do in the community and answering if you can help. Now, don't call me about no foolishness and like, well, what about? I ain't getting into all that because we're too busy trying to do. I'll tell you, some of y'all might want to stay in the past. I'm not going to go back there with you. So the thing is, if you got some bona fide questions and say, man, you know, hey, Fonz, what happened? Well, I just told you what happened. Anyway, so if you got any other questions about MCDC, come to the horse's mouth. I am the horse. And I ain't going to lie to y'all because y'all don't have no heaven or hell to put me in or nothing else. I'm a grown man. I get to my own stuff. You know what I mean? And my heart is right. I'm just trying to do something good with some good people. Doggone it. I'm in the middle of, God couldn't have picked me up and put me in a better community than he did here. He put me right in the middle around people that know stuff. And already got a good heart. I didn't do anything. I haven't created a new way of thinking with any of them. They were already ready, ripe and ready. Yes, that's why I trust God. That, and you know what? They're all believers too. I don't want to get into it, but they're all believers in our group. And for those who always got a knife in their hand, they steal too. Y'all can stay there with that one. Anyway, I got to go, man. I'm feeling pretty good. I was so excited to get on here because I wanted to just share in an honest way what's going on in our community and what we're looking forward to in the future. Now, there will be a press release coming out of DCD. I'm just starting to learn these initials. Department of Community Development. We're working on a press release in regards to our first-time home buyers program. So, you know, we want those who desire to be first-time home buyers. You don't know where to start. And we are going to walk you through the process, connect you to all these entities that will eventually get you where you want to go. I think they got like a $20,000 kitty for individuals who want to purchase a home in Coastville. Shucks, I might sell this and try it again. No, I'm only kidding. But that's what's happening. And look, this, we're new with this. So we may stumble and fall, but we in it to win it. When we fall, we're going to fall forward. Believe that. Hey, look, any questions? Because I got to go. My lovely wife just came home. I want to drink me a Mountain Dew. And I want to call it a night. Anybody got questions? Come on now. Did I miss anybody? I'm here. Now, I'm going to share this on all the pages because I'm going to give everybody the opportunity to do what they do. Kimberly Day Harding, ladies and gentlemen, she is one of the facilitators of Coastville's Black Media Renaissance. You see, behind closed doors, but while a lot of us are sleeping, they are doing some things and they are trying to bring the voices of our community to the forefront culturally, artistically, legislatively, and there's been about 9 or 10 of us have been meeting since the beginning of time, it seems, and it's going to bear fruit. Oh, Courtney said his nephew works at Alice. Yeah, they was telling me that. Kimberly and Miss Vanessa Briggs, Sophia Hansen. Who else we got? We got Tammy Dally Blackman. Man, we got some heavy hitters that is planning something magnificent. I hope you've been catching my snippets in regards to CBMR, because we're going to bring this. Look, man, get on this hope train, man, because there ain't nobody playing with nobody, man. We got stuff to do. This is beautiful, amazing. We got a Jenny that's on it. We got Michelle Williams Allen. We got Shanina Diana. We got Kevin Davis. Now, I might go and forget somebody because I'm just bringing up. You got me on it. Who else we got on? We got Heather Myers on it. It better be a last name. We got Heather on there, spoken word. Who else we got on there, doggone? It's some other people. We got DJ Jones on it. We have a diverse group of people that's putting together plans on how we can best reach and provide a platform by which our voices can be heard. If you looked on my page lately, I've been putting some articles on by Procter & Gamble about how we need to address racism and all that other stuff, man. Y'all stay in touch with us, man, because we're trying to do some stuff. Hey, look, since there ain't no question, all hearts and minds clear, y'all continue to pray for MCDC and each other, man. Pray for each other, man, because that's important. Now, I just hit a button here. And it seems like I can't. What did I just hit? Oh, there. Man, I hit a button and made stuff disappear. Hey, look, nobody told you that they love you today, man. I love you. MCDs loves you. My baby case love you. And I gotta go. So remember, Coatesville's rising. Lisa, you all late. I'm gonna put the link on your page. Coatesville's rising, and peace out. Bam.